Hey guys, welcome back to The Wandering Wind. Today we are starting on Act 3 of Chapter 1, A New Star Approaches. Today we are going to be traveling to the floating palace of the Liyue Qixing Ningguang. Wow, that's going to be interesting. Or the Liyue Tianxuan Ningguang. So, we need to get to the top of the mountain there, right? Okay, maybe I can do it. I might be able to do it. Let's see. If I just... avoid fights? Yeah, well, that ain't gonna happen now. Hey, you know what? You're mean. Hey, Slimo. Hey, Slimeball, get out of here. And you're down. Excellent. And you're down too. Excellent. Excellent. Got some good stuff. And now I can start climbing the rock face. Crap, really? Now we got rain to worry about. Yeah, well, hopefully it's not going to storm and hit me. Yeah, well. We got thunder already. Yay. Lightning and thunder. Oh, that's fun. Yay.
Look up there. That's the Jade Chamber.
That's pretty high up.
This is bad. Paimon's supposed to be your guide, but Paimon doesn't know.
You're only realizing that now. Has to be a way up nearby. Maybe it's whatever this is pointing me to. Oh, really? One of those wind mechanic things? Maybe it's the way up. Looks like some sort of trap.
No way. Just trust Paimon's in.
Okay. First of all, let's try making it daytime. That way, hopefully, the weather will clear up a bit. No? Okay, well, it's worth a shot. All right. Aizo, get out of here. You're the only other animo character I've got.
Washed all the clues away.
Ah, come on, really? Best we go back to Liyue and ask.
Huh? Why?
The way up shouldn't be a secret.
Oh, alright. Let's follow you. Oh. It looks like we've gotten close to the Guizhong Ballista. Paimon has a new idea.
No, Paimon. No.
Right.
Still, I do remember that this ballista had a scope.
Oh, that's right. Now that you mention it, we could use.
First of all, let's get the test.
Oh, it's all coming out now.
Yep. Where is the ballista? Oh. It's that way. Okay. Right. Right. Okay. Yeah, I get it. Now it'll be time to come down. Down, down to Goblin Town. Okay. I'm here. What do I do? Oh. I see. I have to go and talk to those Millenleth, don't I? Okay. Hey, boys.
Halt! Who trespasses on these hallowed grounds?
Hallowed what now? These are the wilds of Mount Tianyin.
Exactly. What are you? We're invited guests. What makes you think you can treat us like this?
Right? I'm quite sure that's not the case.
What? We're just on guard duty. What do you mean, shameless? What nonsense. Seize these suspicious intruders at once.
Well, here they come. Line them up and knock them down.
Do I have to? Again? And I don't even have a proper party this time around. Darn it, I shouldn't have used all my... Okay. Increase attack. Yes. Hey, that's actually pretty decent. Here we go.
Stop.
What's this all about?
Lady Kuching, these two strange people.
Who are you calling strange?
You want to go to the Jade Chamber? Who are you?
We're invited guests here to look for the.
Well, as it happens, I am one of the Liyue Qixing.
Oh, of course you are.
I'm Kuching, the Yuhung of the Qixing.
Good thing.
I know of you, traveler. You're Ningguang's guests, yes?
Mm-hmm.
Didn't expect to meet you here in the mountains. Wow.
Paimon didn't think we'd meet some super rich big shot out here in the middle of nowhere either.
The Guizhong Ballista in Tianheng Pass has long been in disrepair. And yet, it was fixed in a single night. I came here to investigate that occurrence. These Millilith are just here to guard the scene, not to arrest anyone.
Right.
So, this was all a misunderstanding? Paimon never would have thought.
Thinking isn't that hard, Paimon. Come on, you're better than this.
Anyway, for a mortal to be able to repair an Adepti mechanism is quite the mystery, even to the Qixing.
Right.
That was...
Paimon, don't say anything. Not at all.
Just call me Kuching. I'd say that Ningguang's purpose is to request that the savior of Mayuan take a more neutral stance. Or at least, to not wholly side with the Adepti.
We're not taking sides. We spoke with the Adepti. They want to protect Liyue as well.
When you say protect, you're referring to their sanctimonious arrogance, aren't you?
Oof. Dang. She's got something against the guy, the immortals, don't they?
They would have regarded you as someone with the ability to assassinate a god. Naturally, they would also regard Ningguang's locking down the area, questioning the citizenry, and pursuit of the assassin to be pointless work. Perhaps they even wonder if there might be a cover-up. I'll say it like it is. They're underestimating us.
Well, you've got a point there. Still,
well,
should I respect the shallow sense of time and condescension to mortals that has caused them to delay in moving against us, Qixing? Forget
right.
it. I shouldn't speak of them this way. This skepticism is mine alone, and Ningguang does not share it. Either way, I will admit that the actions of the Adepti this time were quite restrained. Rex Lapis's death is indeed an extraordinary circumstance. But to think that they would call for a council of Adepti rather than come down here directly. How surprisingly civilized of them.
Any chance you could talk it out with them?
Well, for Ningguang, she would talk anything and everything out if she could. But I doubt we can do that here. The time of the
right.
Adepti has long passed. If even the Liyue Qixing don't want to face that truth,
what future is there for Liyue?
Super bold statement.
Right?
I'll stop here. Honestly, I hadn't intended to say so much. But you're a good listener, traveler.
I try.
We should both be off to the Jade Chamber. Don't be late now. Ningguang's schedule is packed to the gills all the way till next year.
Oh, gosh.
The cream of Liyue's mercantile crop all see ascending to the Jade Chamber as the greatest honor. Each brings rich gifts as they visit, all to curb
favor.
Favor? That's not the point. Paimon, it's not the point.
But, that's right. Greeting gifts are a staple.
Ah, so eager, sir.
All right. You can decide on your greeting gift. You didn't actually have to come to Mount T. Well, then. May we meet again, traveler.
Well, that Yuhung may not respect the gods, but Paimon thinks she's a pretty cool person.
She made a good impression on me, too.
So, what should we give to Ningguang when we see her?
You really have shifted focus, haven't you, Paimon?
Oh, right! Paimon dreamed of an amazing...
Sugar-frosted slime.
Shoot, Paimon has a feeling that it would be perfect. Why don't we give that for a gift?
Okay. Recipe.
But Paimon's sure that we just need to let's go gather ingredients. Time waits for no one, and neither will our riches.
Riches? Paimon. Here's something else, Paimon. Ah, wonderful. I've got to go to the ruins, and... Oh, really, that's it. Sure, let's go to Dunyu Ruins. I guess cryo slime. Yep, I knew it. Oh wait, no, hydro slime.
It looks crystal clear and very delicious. That's the one. Shadows of fate.
Mom. All right, now what? All right, now we gotta go to the center of it. Like gelatin, huh? Okay. Gosh, what now?
Huh? Is it just Paimon? Huh? Did you hear that?
Someone was calling for help, huh? Great.
There's no end to this. Direct assault.
Hey, delve into destiny. Scatter.
Come on.
Finally done. You're open.
Come on.
Truth hurts.
There we go. Now I got the cage key.
Thank you for your help, kind travelers. If you hadn't come to my aid, I surely would have rotted in this cell. Those treasure hoarders, when their mood was good, they'd rearrange those pots of sweet flowers. When they were in a bad mood,
they'd rearrange my face. Ow. That sounds painful.
I understand. Don't worry. I will compensate you both.
There's really no need. No need at all.
Don't say that. I'm Meng Dan, a supplier for Ming-Ching Jewelry in Liyue Harbor. I often walk around these mountains in search of antiques. I never expected that those treasure hoarders would have their eyes on the same ruins that I had. Before I knew it, they'd caught and imprisoned me. Is there anything that you lack? Antiques, treasure, various knickknacks, you name it.
Wait a moment. Actually, do you have a box that can store presents? We'd like a pretty one. The kind that you can use to store snacks.
Okay.
Of course we do. How can one sell antiques without gift boxes? Now just give me a
moment
and I'll let the
Great! Paimon sugar frosted slime now comes in a beautiful.
Alrighty then, Paimon. Go to Ming-Ching Jewelry. Grab the box and then take the slime and then go see the Tian Xuan. Oh, it's 8:20 already. Dang. I've been up a while making these videos.
A guy called Meng Dan told us
Uncle Meng already told me of many of the best goods in our store here. This contains.
Yep. Hang on a moment.
Sure. Please help yourself.
Traveler, this clay pot looks really awesome. If we use an antique as our mix, it's done! The one and only sugar frosted slime!
Oh, yes. You might want to use.
Woohoo! It looks beautiful!
I'm still not sold on the good idea, but.
Now okay. That we've put all that we've got.
Icing on the slime. Okay. Writing. Good.
According to Kuching, excuse me, do you sell the moon here?
Yes. How many would you?
It's not convenient to speak of numbers here.
Ah, well said. Please use this to send to the.
Yep.
And yet the code they used was not the one for guests, but for the Yuang. What's going on here?
A lot more than you think. A lot more than you think. Or maybe it's more appropriate to say a lot more than you think.
I've been waiting for you, returnee from Joyun Karst.
It's Ningguang. Since this is our first meeting.
Oh, for me. You have my thanks. It seems that I have made things difficult for you, considering that you were supposed to be my guests.
Nice place, this Jade Chamber.
This palace floats in the skies, higher than the peak of any mountain. From this vantage point, one may survey all of Liyue.
All of it,
I have
huh?
been gathering the funds necessary to build it from the time I began learning the merchant's craft. And since becoming the Tianxuan, I have spared no effort in hiring the best craftsmen to constantly extend it.
Constantly,
first,
huh?
It was but the size of one room. Now it is large enough to blot out the moon in the skies above Liyue.
Nice.
One day, I believe it will overshadow all seven nations.
Well, she doesn't lack for ambition, that's for sure.
Not many from outside Liyue earn the right to ascend the Jade Chamber. But I have been in correspondence with the acting Grand Master of the Knights of Favonius, who spoke highly of you.
Well, thank you.
As such, I have been putting eyes and ears out ever since you reached Liyue.
Nice.
What?
And I finally got wind of your movements when you were on the way to Wangshu
Inn. Wangshu Inn, nice.
Everyone at Wangshu Inn is one of ours.
Crap. Come on, what did I tell you about your language?
At the Guizhang Ballista. I fear that peeking would have been a little difficult from this altitude. Our eyes and ears are more than sufficient. You two are very interesting people, after all. It would be not. Well, I wouldn't expect you to trust us, considering that you have had far more interactions with the Adepti. The reason I invited you here was to clear up some misunderstandings.
Right. Okay. Sure. What are the misunderstandings, may I ask?
I believe that you've heard of the Archon War.
Only in the broadest of strokes.
Many gods used to walk this earth, and many long wars were fought between them that did not abate until 2,000 years ago. Much blood was shed, and many lives were lost.
Oof.
In the end, only seven victors remained standing in Tibet. Cities and nations on the corpses of the vanquished. And thus began the era of the Seven. You can see Goyun Stone Forest from here, I trust. It is no natural rock formation. Those are giant spears of rock hurled by Rex Lapis during the war. Beneath the spears lie those cast down by Rex Lapis in those days, gods that failed to seize the title of Archon. Not only is it true that gods may die, but so too has the membership of the Seven changed over the last two millennia.
Rex Lapis's
passing is an unimaginable disaster for Liyue. But the Order of the Seven will not collapse simply because of that. Another Lord will arise sooner or later. Yet, how are we to forget Rex Lapis? When that time comes, the relationship between the people of Liyue and the gods and Adepti will surely be different from before. In a new era, the Liyue Chi Sing remain Rex Lapis's former subjects. Do you really think us capable of having played a part in his demise?
Well, then why hide the body?
That day at Yujing Terrace, it was also very sudden. Even I was caught completely off guard. But our enemy has long lain hidden within the harbor. If we do not act against them now, they will surely gain the upper hand. Hiding the Imperial was a necessary maneuver to take the initiative back, to play the spider while our foes scurry about.
Who's this enemy you're talking about?
Oh, come on, Paimon, are you not listening?
What do you think, Traveler?
Is it him? It's him, isn't it?
Well answered. The scenery out here is fine indeed, but the wind is a little strong.
Let's go inside. And see what it is that we... Why is it that every time I've got a cutscene, it seems like the weather has to change to rain? Every time.
Oh well. What a huge hall! Paimon's never seen such a fancy place before.
Right. Me either. Except that I have, but not in this playthrough.
Be at ease, you two. Make yourselves at home if you wish.
Probably will.
I have invited you two here as friends. And when friends come over to play, our enjoyment comes first.
Is that what I think it is?
Why, you've kept your ear to the ground, I see.
That's because even the storytellers are talking about it. Everyone's after a piece of paper from that wall. It's super famous.
Nice.
That's because that wall records Leo's secrets. Merchants have always been attracted to secrets. But the secrets of the mercantile world are of no interest to you, are they, Traveler? You're rather special, really, and I think you're quite aware of that.
Oh, I am.
If possible. But if you were to choose the more trustworthy person between myself and Kuching...
Well, between your orthodoxy and her heterodoxy, I'd go with the Kuching and her skepticism of the divine.
I originally thought her a bit too... hard-headed. With someone of her character on the Chi Sing, I've had some extra messes to clean up behind the scenes.
Oh my.
But after she said those words, the time of the Adepti has long passed. If even the Liyue Chi Sing don't want to face that truth, then what future is there for Liyue?
Oof.
Well, I must say that quite a few of my doubts have been dispelled. I won't deny that Rex Lapis's passing seems advantageous to us. But, for Liyue's sake, we cannot allow ourselves to be shackled by rumors of our usurpation of power.
I surmise that the Fatui has a hand in these.
Indeed. It seems that you understood what I meant. I called for the gag order and for the Exuvia to be hidden to temporarily stabilize the situation, and also to prevent something similar to the incident in Mondstadt. With Rex Lapis's death, the Fatui have busied themselves with many clandestine actions beyond their diplomatic remit. As the Tian Chuan, one responsible for Liyue, I cannot be too concerned with appearances when opposing them. Allowing the rite of parting to take place was also meant to buy some time for us to take control of Liyue's administration.
It's exactly as Zhang Li said. The Chi Sing only provided the venue for their rite so they could use us for their own ends. Wait, that's right. Speaking of ends, could I...
Of course.
Lyman's heard heard that anyone who sends a greeting gift gets a little something in return. So, does that include us?
Only Paimon. Come on!
Well, we have made quite a bit of trouble for you recently. How about this?
Yay! Paimon was just... One of the sheets on that wall! Don't look at Paimon like that! One of these sheets of... Just imagine.
Well... I'm thinking that the map is probably the interesting thing. If you get the map and you find out what it's talking about, you can end up getting a whole lot of valuable information.
Huh? Well, that was an easy search. There's a place marked with a circle on here. Sigil of permission, something, something, Fatui, research, copy.
Now they're making the copies of the sigils of permission.
That doesn't sound like... Oh, this piece of paper... Oh, Ningguang did say that the Fatui have been up to all kinds of mischief in the shadows of Liyue. Spreading rumors, wanting to get their hands on the Archon's body and whatnot.
Oof.
But research on the sigil of permission? Paimon wonders what they're up to.
Well, they didn't have a depth of power.
And the sigil of permission. Seems there's still more for us to find out.
It's all unfolding a little too perfectly.
Oh, well, should we? Oh, so you're saying that it's precisely because we can't completely trust Ningguang that we should confirm the truth of what she says for ourselves. That's what. Anyway, we'll, before we look for Zhongli at Dihua Marsh, let's go to the place marked out on these papers and see if the Fatui are up to no good there.
So we're gonna have to fight, aren't we? Please don't make me fight a ruined guard. Please don't make me fight a ruined guard. Oh gosh. No, we're not gonna make you fight a ruined guard. It'll be something worse, I bet. What could be worse than a ruined guard? Well, I mean, we're not on Dragonspine, but a ruined Greater, a ruined Drake. If we were in Sumeru. Oh, what's? Oh gosh, it's gonna be a ruined hunter, isn't it? It's gonna be a ruined hunter, isn't it? It's a ruined hunter. I know it is. I know it is. Got to be a ruin hunter. Okay. Well.
One need not scry to know today's weather will be good.
One need not scry to know that today's weather will be good. Oh yeah, sure. Sure, you don't have to scry to know that, but you definitely need to get out of the house. The only problem is getting out of the house requires a lot more work. And you might think that there should be. Come on. There we go. Got you. Dang it! Really? I knew I was getting in some trouble, but I didn't know it was going to be this darn bad.
My vision is clouded. Go, go, Baron Bunny! I'll race you there!
Don't ask to join my world right now, please. Alright. I'm gonna die either way. Might as well at least get some recovery out of this. Okay. Party set up.
Vision is clouded.
Let's end this quickly.
Not so hard.
I mean,
bet you can't keep up with me.
Oh no.
Scatter. The stars.
Damn you.
Let's end this quickly.
No escape.
Almost.
That's cheating.
Dang. Okay. There we go. They're trying to reproduce.
Paimon's seen this pattern. Oh, Paimon knows
Adepti end up in the hands of someone like Child?
It's not just a relic.
Oh, that's right. Cloud Retainer said that when talismans like that were once, maybe the Fatui are copying this, at being able to channel divine power in battle? That sounds pretty.
They're definitely up to something bad. Alright. Dihua Marsh. Nice. Okay, well, I guess that's gonna be part. Definitely not gonna be able to do this in two parts this time. Alright, well, one more part, hopefully, and I'll be done with this particular story. Well, Archon Quest. And we can start heading towards being able to go to Inazuma. But until next time, guys, God bless you and have a wonderful day. Thanks for being here and thanks for watching. Bye.